promised an episode today. What am I supposed... But I know that. I know that. No, wait, don't hang up. Oh, hello. Something came up. Well, you see, you remember how I, promised an episode for, today? Well, it seems the Improv Collective has, pushed up its, premiere schedule. So, I have no content this week. But don't worry. I have a special selection of review shows pre-recorded for just such an emergency. So I, for this week, I shall be choosing, a charity show. Because, after all, charities are for those who are in need, and, I'm in need! So, this show shall feature, Sam, Fernando, Anna, Teresa, Ryan, Kit, and Carla. Oh, and, some loser named, Henny? Kenny. Kenny. Yeah, sounds like an idiot. Anyway, there's not going to be much to talk about for this, episode. I mean, what's to say about a charity show? So I wish, you know, something would happen. Anything. For you. My friends.
Why, hello there, strange person in weird clothes who rushed in my room without permission, or rhyme or reason. How may I help you?
Must destroy all weirdos!
Wait a moment.
Preparing attack program! Processing.
Well, this is going to take a while. On with the show.
Now, all of us here at the Collective, we don't have time for any of that. We all come from broken homes. We can't memorize things. We have very short attention spans. So what we're going to do tonight is we're going to take suggestions from you, the audience, and we're going to whip those out into 2 to 3 minute scenes. Everything you will see tonight, we made up completely on the spot. I'm going to be asking for suggestions throughout the night. So I might say something like, what's your favorite color? And you would say?
Blue.
Rainbow sherbet.
Not too many favorite colors in here. All right. I might say something like, what's your favorite kind of car? And you would say? Side, give me an occupation, some kind of job, and you would say,
Janet, a pony!
And everybody over here, tell me who you don't want to be president, and you might say,
a pony!
Okay, I wouldn't vote for a pony either. I wouldn't vote for
a pony.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's dead!
Oh,
it's okay, he's not a real pony.
Yes, he is.
He exists in your heart, and that's all that matters.
Where can the pony at?
I'm not going to debate this with you. My wife, ladies and gentlemen, my wife is in the audience. So, that's all that you really need to know. We're going to be coming out here, we're going to be doing some games, some well-practiced formatted games, but within all of those games, everything will be made up completely, spontaneously, and on the spot. Now, as I said before, this is a very special show because this is a charity show. 100% of the proceeds tonight are going to be going to the AIDS Foundation. I'm sorry, it's the AIDS Services Foundation of Orange County. And to tell us a little bit about that foundation, I'd like to invite Natalia up here on stage.
Hi everyone, like you said, my name is Natalia. I work at AIDS Services Foundation for the family programs. So we serve the population of families that have kids from ages 5 to 17, and their children who are affected or infected by HIV and AIDS. And we have programs like a Kids Club, which is the reason they're coming for us tonight. And that program is every Thursday for kids from ages 7 to 17. And they come together every Thursday for support, emotional support. They come from very, very difficult homes. And this is like their house where they can come in and they have the support, and they have a group where they can experience things together, have fun, art. So it's a really great program. We also find movie tickets, we go to camp, we do all sorts of fun things for the kids. And we do other stuff. We do serve clients that are not in families, and they do like, they do case management, social service services, and a whole lot of stuff. Yeah.
You are helping out that foundation. If you'd like to give another donation, it's right there up at the front. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to have a good time tonight?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready to have a good time tonight? Yeah. Well, today I introduce your players for this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Kenny standing. We're going to start this show off with a game we like to call Beastie Raps. So, let me explain how the brochures, then you get excited all over again. Ladies and gentlemen, once upon a time, there was a rap trio called the Beastie Boys. The way that they would rap is they would set up a verse, and then they would all rhyme on the last punchline. And that's the way it's going to work. We're going to take a name from somebody out here in the audience, and these two teams are going to have to rap back and forth, and their team are going to have to complete the rhyme. If they don't complete that rhyme, they are out of there, and then they rotate forward. So, can I get a one-syllable name? One-syllable name, please.
Ed.
My name is Ed. Teresa, you are initiating. Ladies and gentlemen, for a warm round of applause, this is Beastie Rap.
Bang!
now that's what I said.
Oh, my tires look like they're losing.
I scoop out the kibble, now the dog is dead.
Everybody, sit down and sit for Carla. squaring yourselves in a square, please.
Same thing.
Come on, now we
are. It's four triangles.
There you go. Alright, so the way this works, ladies and gentlemen, hey,
guys,
they don't know how it's played.
We're sorry, Dad.
Alright, now the way that this works is that we're gonna have four different scenes happening at the same time. We're gonna have a scene going on between these two players right here, and when I say rotate, they're gonna rotate, and then the last line from this scene will become the first line in this scene. So if Kenny says, hello, and I say rotate, then the first thing Sam's gonna say is,
hello.
Could've been a better example than that. So, let me get, What just happened between these two?
Too many bananas.
There are too many bananas. Rotate.
That no problem.
You have an occupation, some kind of job.
Mortician.
Corporate downsizing.
Corporate downsizing.
Wow. Corporate downsizing. Wow. Kind of job. And right here, just give me an object, some kind of object.
Chair.
And rotate, won't be a potpourri, anything at all. Just yell anything at all.
Tree.
All right, rotate. What is your suggestion?
Too many bananas.
Rotate.
Corporate downsizing.
Rotate.
Chair.
Rotate.
Tree.
Rotate. All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, after a warm round of applause, this is the day we're born.
Rick, you're off duty. You know what? You don't have to do that anymore.
Aw.
I know you're working for bananas, so I got you. Oh, buddy, bananas.
This may be too many bananas.
Okay, hey, take it easy.
Okay, this is just slightly too many bananas.
Okay, I'll take them all back. Here, forget it.
So, I think I can take one.
You know, I knew I was had the right guy when I just had a few bananas.
Thank you. I love you too.
Rotate.
I love you too, man. We are gonna take this company down. We're gonna fire everybody.
I'm right there with you. Between you and me, we're gonna go all the way to the top.
Oh my god. We're gonna rule the world. And I swear, when it's all over, we're stomping on people.
That's right. It's gonna be Tom and Steve.
Well, thanks for remembering my name's Tom. Okay, come on.
Well, it's always gonna be the big guy on top and then Steve.
I'm the big guy.
Whoa.
Steve and Tom.
No. That happens. No. That happens, that means that I've gotta work from the inside to take Steve now.
This is kind of a dilemma, isn't it, Chair? I want the Finance Committee, Senator Claiborne, and I will be the chair.
I'll be the chair.
Oh, you will be my whip? The number two in the Finance Committee.
That's what you mean, my whip.
You give up so easily, Senator Claiborne.
Yeah, you know, yeah, with
wording. Will you have some brandy, Senator Claiborne?
Well, as long as I'm whip, I'll have some brandy. That'll be really nice.
Election's coming up this fall, Senator Claiborne. I hear it's getting hot. Can you stand the heat?
Rotate.
Can you stand the heat?
Yeah, I'm a tree.
I'm a lumberjack.
You dick.
Yes, I am.
You killed my dad, probably.
I don't know. I've chopped a lot of trees. I'll check it out.
No, no, stop! Why do you want to do this?
Well, you see...
Did your parents not love you? Here, have some acorns.
This is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Well, time to chop it down.
Branches envelop him!
Wait, let me down!
Rotate! Please let me down!
No! I gotta talk to my lawyers,
doesn't matter. I want actual pay. And I will do horrible things. Hold my evil monkey tips.
Okay, hold on. I've got something on top of you. Go take.
Got something in my pocket for you, Tom. Don't you walk in the universe?
Was that a sandwich package? Was that a retirement plan? For my kids?
This is downsizing. Now you don't get any of that stuff. You're lucky you even get your butt kicked all the way out.
You're heartless.
I know. But I'm the rule. Remember, I warned you. I told you.
Rotate.
I warned you, I told you, Senator Claiborne, that I would be the chair, but no, you wheelie-dealy, now you're the chair of the Senate Finance Committee.
Yep. Yeah, your mouth. Whip!
You better whip me good.
Rotate. You better whip me good.
With a chainsaw!
So, I know I killed your father.
Yes, I am the great and horrible Lumberjack Jr. And now, I'll have revenge!
Jose! I have revenge. I appreciate being lathered in bananas and then hung out to dry at the monkey zoo.
You can't take a joke, right?
Rotate!
No. I'm kidding!
Oh, now you're kidding. Listen. No, I want you to watch. Rotate!
I want you to watch, Senator Claiborne, as I pour you another brandy.
Well, there, I'll be happy to watch as you know.
Rotate!
I'll be happy to watch as you know.
Finish me off.
Yes.
Finish me off. Finish me off.
One, that Sam does not know how to operate the slide on a gun. And two, Fernando is the only person in this entire room who knows how the mechanics of the Senate works.
I do.
So, can I see the next four players up, please? And except for one person. Okay. Rusty, get out of here. Everybody say goodbye, other players. Game called Chain Murder.
Ooh.
Yeah. Now, the way this works is that somebody has been killed.
Ooh.
And, much like the game Clue, they've been killed with an object in a very special place. Now, because this is improv, and by definition things have to be a little bit out of the ordinary, it's not going to be an ordinary person killed, not an ordinary weapon used, and not an ordinary place where it happens. Also, Hanna is going to have to communicate all three of these things to her team members without using any actual language. She's going to have to speak entirely in gibberish. So that's how the game is played. So, who was killed? Either a historical figure or a pop culture figure, someone like
Britney Spears.
Too soon.
Britney Spears. I heard Britney Spears. Britney Spears. What was the murder weapon? Something you wouldn't normally kill somebody with.
A spoon. Animal crackers.
You can kill someone with a spoon. Animal crackers, that's a little bit tougher. Animal crackers. And location. Where did this happen?
A volcano.
Okay. Volcano. Alright, so Hannah, who was killed?
Britney Spears.
What were they murdered with?
Animal crackers.
And where did it happen?
A volcano.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, you got the gist of the game. Let's put a warm round of applause together and call our player. Let's play!
Ha ha ha!
2 seconds.
Even farther from the truth. Teresa!
Simba!
his entire filmography. I'd like to see Fernando Ryan give up here, please. Just a regular scene, we're gonna get a suggestion from you guys, then they'll perform that scene. But any point during that scene, I can yell Scantron, and they all have to get up here in a line, and they have to give me a suggestion for what happens next in the scene. So say somebody's at the doctor, I yell Scantron, and I go, Fernando, why is he at the doctor?
RoboCop.
And I say, Ryan, why is he at the doctor?
Hit by a car.
And I say, Kip, why is he at the doctor?
Herpes.
That is very valid reason. Okay. And we'll choose one of those, and the scene will go on. So, first, I need a suggestion, a location,
The morgue.
The morgue. The morgue. Ladies and gentlemen, after warm applause, this is the game of Scantron.
Another dead body, huh?
Another one bites the dust.
There's a murderer in town.
Bob. You wouldn't know who did it, would you?
Well, I'm on the case, Ted. I don't know what you're insinuating.
Kendra, what is the name of the killer on the loose?
Slicing McDicey.
Super happy, fun time, Mega Man dude. Oh
my God. Double dagger do you good.
Go with double dagger do you good.
He's got a limp.
Not only that, he has cuts all over the place. Look at all those incisions.
They call me Double Dagger, do you good?
God, you can't
have two daggers and I'm gonna do you good. Case solved, I guess.
Case closed.
Oh, you think the case is closed, but you two are gonna be opened.
Ooh. Hey, let me have my last smoke, okay? Come on.
No smoking allowed in the moor.
All right, Double. All right, do it. Come on, I know you're your jollies by
Wait! Mind.
You can do that to him. You guys have been childhood friends.
Sandra! Where were they childhood friends?
Band camp.
The banking academy.
They say band camp.
You always could play flute better than me.
It's not my fault that you were a tuba player.
Yeah, well, those pretty fingers aren't gonna be doing much after I'm done with them. You know what I'm gonna do with them?
What are you gonna do? Double dagger, do you doo doo?
You know what? You blew your own cover. That's not all you'd be blowing tonight.
What is he gonna be blowing tonight?
Steve.
Our dead corpses.
His flute.
His flute. Feel the flute. Feel the flute.
My intuition tells me I'll survive this.
I'd like to hear a requiem on your flute before we go.
Luckily for you, I've got a flute right here. But when I finish my song, you'll be asleep. And then...
Are you Jigglypuff?
Sandra! Is Double Dagger doing you good, Jigglypuff?
Only in a matter of all sense.
Absolutely, yes.
Only on Tuesdays.
On Tuesdays.
Hey, 26 and recount, or
think? I really like how we cut to the chase. That if that CSI, if that was a CSI episode?
Yeah.
Our guests are Carla, Kenny, and Teresa. Here, I'll explain what it is. This is a game. It's a very simple game. These are going to be three family members, and they're going to be having dinner. And that's the whole game. It's just going to be a nice, normal family dinner. And that's it. That is all that happens. So, I just have one suggestion I need to get from you, the audience. What are they having for dinner?
Menudo.
That's
menudo.
You are eating that.
Yes, it's pretty good.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, for a warm round of applause, this is Family Dinner!
Woo! You know, honey, I know you've been sick, so this is gonna be good for your cold and your runny nose and...
It doesn't
But what did he say?
You know, dear Louise. I don't want your little sister hearing this, but you're a really bad influence on her. You didn't use another 2 pounds on you, son of a bitch.
Oh, thank God they didn't find that. I'm not going to finish that sentence.
I'm a greeter at Walmart, so we'll be good.